chat. Hello, Big Mac. Hello, Murdoch. Hello, James. And hello, anyone else who happens to be lurking right now. It is time for another stream. Where the fuck is my... There it is. Alright. Was muted? What? Oh, Lynn. No, Lynn hasn't said anything yet.
Yeah, I'm currently eating lunch.
She's very quiet, though.
That's because I was leaning back in my chair there, I apologize.
I think you're still just quiet. Let me... raise the volume on Discord a bit. Oh, nope. Actually, no, you're just... Let me raise your volume in Discord then.
That and also because like my mic was also off to the side.
Hello, Moonlit. And Moonlit says, nice new video, Lynn.
Cheers. Appreciate that. I mean, as far as reading screenshots for it, we only work with the best here.
It's like, I didn't think Susie would ever agree to voice SS Sniper Wolf. Look, I've voiced stories before.
Yeah, I'd say that's worse. Hard to say if that would be worse, but it's certainly up there.
Yeah. If I get typecasted as the problematic person in a drama, then fucking whatever.
It is what it is.
Anyway, how am I doing? Ever so slightly worse now that I'm out of bed. I was incredibly cozy this morning.
Ah, mood, not gonna lie. I mean, like, half of that is because, like, we were up last night until, like, fucking 2:30 in the morning, but, you know. I was just like, yeah, I do not want to move right now.
Yeah, I was caterpillar mode under two blankets. One of them being really thick. And then, like, my heating pad and my heater is on. Oh, it was so good.
Hell yeah. Good shit.
I really do need to stop using that heating pad as often as I am, though. I think I'm, like, back to really burning my stomach. It's very red again.
Yeah, you might want to stop that.
Well, I have to, unfortunately, because if my stomach starts hurting, that is a really good way of stopping it from hurting. But it does burn my stomach.
As you do.
Also, hello, adversary. Is that Harley BTS? No, but Harley could join. If they wanted to.
It is Harley. I'll drop a picture of my Balenciaga shit in the no mic in order to prove it.
Yeah, Harley could very well join if they wanted to. They are in this chat.
Yee.
Susie denies being cute. Also, Susie is Somft in caterpillar mode sometimes. Well, just because I'm cozy doesn't mean I'm cute. Did I have fun last night with the doc? Yeah. Being on Crafty's open labs are always fun. Did Lin Lin see me play Gun Mario? Yeah, Lin's seen Gun Mario before.
Mm-hmm. That's good shit.
But yeah. The open lab, I probably should have went with my PNG tuber avatar. Cause being on stream, cause I'll admit, I don't really know Gob's lore that well. So knowing that like he turns people into cookies, it's like I don't know if that's like a baker thing or like a scientist thing. But I really should have used my PNG tuber because then it would have been like a call entirely full of people that do science. Well, mine's more alchemy. But that is kind of like a science fiction. So, you shrug. Yeah. So, it would have been really fun to just have a call full of scientists. But, c'est la vie.
It is what it is.
Gob is a cookie mancer. Oh, so it's magic that he does. Okay.
Cookie mancer.
He's a little goblin, and his whole shtick is apparently he turns people into cookies.
We take those.
I know. I do think it's really funny. At the beginning of that call, specifically. I had mentioned that like my chat is like super convinced that I'm a super villain, and then like everyone in the call, because apparently Gob has like a dark self that he plays on his streams or something like in character, and then I'm on a stream with Dr. Crafty, who is basically a villain, and then you have Dr. Caliban, who is also in character a villain. So I was just like the only one in the room that doesn't like have like an evil version or whatever, and I'm just like my chat's like super convinced that I'm a super villain, and then the fucking Caliban's just like, yeah, join us, we have cookies.
Hell yeah.
So I'm like, raise his hands, I don't belong here.
I feel out of place.
It's very funny. Again, if I'd used my alchemist avatar, you know, would have been even better, I think. But again, alas, I decided to use my actual model because I don't get a chance to use it very often.
Yeah.
You're guilty by association, apparently, yeah. Caliban is an evil genius, Gob has cookies, Susie in the middle with her cute army.
Sounds about right.
It was definitely an interesting, like, quartet. That's what I'm thinking of. one with titles The Seven, The Silly S&P, Ponder is the Cartographer, Susie the Alchemist, no idea about it, any other good names. Well, I mean, The Alchemist is just the character that I play in, like, through being a VTuber. On the SMP, if I get my way, then I'm not going to really be doing a whole lot more with potions, because I will be a mushroom. It will be a truffle.
I don't know why that's as fun as it is, but it just is.
Be a mushroom. Truffle.
Yeah. Okay.
Waiting to find a the not appearing in this SMP person. I'm sure we're. Well, I mean, Heaton has yet to appear, I think, in Season 2. I don't know how many times Phineas has appeared in the SMP. Lynn, have you been on the SMP?
I was on briefly since the start of Season 2 for, like, testing, but other than that, I haven't yet, because I am currently cooking, and what I am cooking is not finished yet.
I don't think the Jester has shown up since Season 2. Fiona has yet to show up for Season 2, but Fiona's also kind of trying to replace a computer.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think Streamline has appeared for Season 2 yet.
We take those.
You playing Yu-Gi-Oh or something?
Yeah, because I was testing that ABC brew that I was doing. And when we open a hand of B, Union Hanger, Revolution Synchron, Rite of Aremisir. It is time we cook.
There a commentator that uses Pegasus as their avatar? The Conundrum used to do that a long time ago, but I don't know if the Conundrum even is still a commentator. Kind of don't really pay too much attention to him nowadays. Because last I heard, he was bullying children and raiding people's chats.
Mega cringe.
Children is cringe, yeah. kind of...
It's cringe, but, like, it's just so possible.
I try not to bully children unless it's... This is gonna sound really bad. It's like, I try not to bully children, you know, unless it's funny.
Yeah.
Yalvar still stands if you want to be one of the four horsemen. What if the kid is a bigot? Well, I mean, picking on bigots is always justified. As long as you don't go too far, I guess. I don't tend to with my bullying.
On this stream, Susie Doodletones explains the nuances of bullying children.
I mean, if it's in good fun, like... I think that's kind of like the general MO. As long as it's in good fun and it, like, doesn't raver off into, like, actual abuse.
Yeah.
I mean, we can all kind of agree on that. A little lighthearted bullying, like, is, can be a lot of fun.
Yeah, I mean... Yeah, that's why, just... Banter's great. Ask Aaron. So it looks like the end board that we're able to make with this deck is like Appalooza with two negates, two monster negates, three Omni negates, and ABC Dragon. And even then, this list probably could change up a bit.
Banter is such a good word. Yeah.
True.
That was a loud sneeze. Let's clip it for Avi. Let's not. Avi's heard my sneezes before.
Yeah, wouldn't Avi be in bed or something by now?
No, he's currently on Ponder Street.
Ah, fair enough.
Thoughts on the new Five Nights at Freddy's movie? Not seen it.
Yeah, no spoilers in chat either, because, I still need to watch it either today or tomorrow. Hopefully tomorrow.
Yeah, here's the thing you guys are gonna have to learn about me at some point. It takes me a while to get to a movie, if I get to it at all. I'm not a really big movie watcher.
Thank you.
you know, one thing about the movie that's extremely inconsequential. If it's the thing that was talked about on Twitter pretty much all day yesterday, yeah, I think we all know that now by this point.
Yeah. Like, I already got spoiled on part of it that I was excited to, like, go in blind to see, and I was really disappointed by that. It is what it is.
Biggest spoiler you've heard? It's a movie? Yeah.
Yeah, lucky you if that is the biggest spoiler you've heard, honestly.
Laser entropy. Yeah, I wanted Somft.
Somft.
Yep, S-O-M-F-T. Which meant one thing. Bimbotone's time.
Sorry, I opened my Twitter notifications and I just saw the fucking my PR is bussin' Aaron Tempest.
Yesterday was fucking cracked.
True.
Thank you.
I'm also gonna be, like, in and out, because I'm also recording lines at the same time as doing this, so I'll be it for a sec.
Alright. Finally getting some of the new music I've added into the playlist. It's taken a while. I'm finally getting some. I heard the Wobbly Life music earlier. Now I hear Super Mario RPG song that I added. Those a while ago, and like we're only just now hearing them. How many songs are in your playlist? That is a good question. What you can do is you can exclamation mark playlist, and that'll give you like a full list of every song that I have in the playlist. So I think it's this? Yeah. This should tell you all the songs that I have in my playlist. I think I do keep it up to date, or I try to keep it up to date. I've got roughly 2,630 songs. From how many games? I have no idea. I have not kept count of that. But yeah. We got 2,630. Get scratching. Whoops, I didn't mean to do that. Let's get scratching. Are you gonna make a commentary where you use the sing, 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 everybody's gotta sing it as the intro again? I mean, that's my default intro now. That's been my normal intro, or my default intro, for a little bit now. Since I want to say the Vincent Skullman comp, basically all year. As for the next time I'm going to use that, well, currently I'm taking a bit of a break from commentaries. I've got other projects that I want to work on. Remember that one Kickstarter where you gain access to a playlist with over 2k songs? You think Critical mentioned it at one point, you know, you gotta pay 10 grand? I have no idea. I must have missed out on that video. Hey, Dragonite. Remember when Lynn used heat waves for her vids? Fair enough. Hey, Hyperdrive. Remember to save every 5 minutes because all digital art programs have given you trust issues? Oh, you're gonna hate watching me then. Program crashes on me and it's like not restorable, I'm just like, well, that one wasn't meant to be. Let's try that again. It's like Timmy Turner saying what could possibly go wrong. You know, with me, there's a lot of things that could possibly go wrong. But like, shrug. It's not like I'm doing this for a job or anything. You have a fun fact about Bubsy? Sure, what is this fun fact? The game developers are making the second game, they would stab a plush doll of him to vent their frustrations. That's kind of funny. Yeah, the Cuphead devs remortgaging their house to fund the game. Yeah. That was pretty wild. So as he goes hard, but it's up tongue and rough, but yeah. Fun fact, Danganronpa is OST goes hard. I've never heard this track before. It sounds so Toho. I have no idea. watch from V3. It's up in the corner. If you ever want to know what song is playing at any given time, or from what game, just look no further than up here. Up in the corner here. Now, I heard about the John Romero's head and the icon of sin. What a cozy looking piece. Yeah. The idea. I wanted Somft. I wanted Somft. So I'm getting both. Keeping it. That way is probably for the better. Just make it orange. I guess the point across well enough. Well, again, adversary, I've been drawing those little smalls for about as long as Reddit has been a thing. Not really, like, they're not at all inspired by Reddit. How am I gonna do this, shading? Precisely why I tend to do flats. No, actually we want from upper. So we want this. Looking up at the sun. Do I remember my Gaia Online username? Probably still just Doodletones. I haven't logged into Gaia though in fucking God knows how long. Like, I don't even think I was out as trans by the point that I last logged into Gaia. What year did I find out I was trans? last year that I was in public high school, so it had to have been like, say 2012-ish? Something like that? It was when I was 15. Is that a Starbucks cup? Very possibly. That did kind of make Bimbo Tones a bit of like a... kind of like fit a lot of the basic white girl stereotypes. Or what is considered the basic white girl stereotype. I don't know. I thought it was cute. I'm not actually a big coffee drinker myself. I was much more of a soda drinker when I still had caffeine in my veins. But I have not had caffeine in... I'd say like half a year. I've been off caffeine for a bit now. I did kind of make Bimbo Tones white, yeah. Well, it's the, specifically the basic white girl stereotypes. So Bimbo Tones would definitely be the one that would have like a fucking pumpkin spice latte at around this time of year. Probably. Like the first image that I drew outside of the reference, she had like boba tea. So Yeah. That probably is pumpkin spice latte. Bet she's wearing those beige boots with the white fluff. Where you put the hole to put it on. Oh, you mean Ugg boots? Yeah. I did draw the Ugg boots.
Hello, I am here very quickly just to inform you that I am aware that you're streaming. Hello, everyone in the audience. And while we will be playing Danganronpa, do not interrupt your stream, Bert. And I'm sorry if I scared you, okay?
Wait, what?
I started the call in the group chat and I didn't want to scare you.
Oh, I have streamer mode on, so I didn't hear it.
Okay, good. I'll see you later. Enjoy your stream, and I hope you guys have a great day.
Yeah. Lumi has kicked back the Danganronpa brain rot with me. Sorry, he sparked back up my Danganronpa brain rot. You order from Starbucks is about shop. I've never actually shopped at Starbucks, so too poor for that shit. Are you kidding? I really want to make the bad joke. It's like I can't even afford Twitter Blue, man. Like, how the fuck am I supposed to afford a coffee? Smile. his order from Starbucks? No, I don't. As I said, I'm too poor. And then I made a funny little joke about how Elon Musk was like, oh, you buy coffee from Starbucks, and that's like super expensive, but you can't afford Twitter Blue. It's like, no, I don't drink from Starbucks, actually. It's too expensive for me, too. If we didn't spend our life savings on avocado toast, we'd buy a house. Yeah. This might be just fine. Believe it is. Yeah, no, I can't go to Starbucks, you know? I can't afford Twitter Blue. How could I possibly afford a drink from Starbucks? During pandemic, Starbucks said, fuck it, we'll sell our customers the powder that we mix to make our coffee since no one's allowed to go outside anymore. Yeah. People had to learn how to make their own drinks.
I am back.
Welcome back.
Alright, let's see what you're cooking. Nice, nice.
Yeah, currently we were just talking about Starbucks. And I was just like, dude, how could I possibly go to Starbucks? I can't even afford Twitter Blue, smile.
Bruh. Honestly, I've never been to Starbucks. Is that any good?
I'm not yet. Like, when I genuinely have not ever been to Starbucks for anything except their Wi-Fi once when I was downloading Pokemon Y.
Nice, nice.
is the literal only time I've ever been to a Starbucks in my entire life.
Understandable.
We get onto that topic because someone was wondering if what I had drawn in Bimbo Tones' hands is a Starbucks cup. And I was just like, you know what? I basically have made Bimbo Tones very, like, basic white girl coded. So probably.
I mean, yeah. Sounds about right.
What?
Sorry, I just seen, what's it, on Twitter, someone posted a Salamangreat deck profile, deck list, right, and it has a Ryukoki in it.
Huh.
Wait, what?
We see my boy finally get use?
Yeah, but like... in Salamangreat?
I don't know.
What is the synergy here?
I have to say, someone's obviously found a reason to like... what was it? Put two back into the deck?
It is what it is.
Right now the meta is catch tier up early and arguably tier laments, so you just want to cry? Fair enough.
I mean, yeah. Wait, which ones did they say, sorry?
Catch tier up, pearly, and arguably tier laments.
Yeah, pearly and tier laments, yeah. Catch tier has fell off now. Catch tier is dead. Like you see some people doing like fringe war crime builds of the deck, but in terms of like Cash Tira actually being Cash Tira, it can't really do that without a Rise Heart. Cause it's like how the meta has its like top three decks in terms of like YCS performances being, I'm pretty sure, Pirelli, Unchained, and Rescue Ace.
I was actually about to say, currently, on the site that I use to keep track of the meta, currently it says Unchained, Cash Tier, and Branded.
Huh?
That's what it currently says.
Branded occasionally, but like I certainly wouldn't put it in the top three because like, well, I mean it's because it's like it depends in that sense if they're counting the branded as well as the branded Chimera separately or together.
Branded Despia, branded Anti-Meta, Adventurer, branded Despia. Yeah.
Yeah.
Does count those.
Fair enough. But yeah, because it's like, because I remember like that tweet where it's just like, yeah, Yu-Gi-Oh! Is currently in the pet store meta with dogs, cats, and fire hydrants.
Yeah, Rescue Ace is on the list, but it's like number 10 on the list here.
Which honestly, with it winning the last YCS, I'd probably say that it should be a bit higher.
Well, it counts how many decks have been like topping, and so Rescue Ace, there's apparently only been two in the past like 3 months. There was one in Vancouver and one in Cancun, Mexico.
Okay, in that case, I'm pretty sure that list is probably out of date then, because it just won Indianapolis.
It might be a little bit out of date then, but it tends to keep up with the meta. That's why I use it.
Yeah.
Like, it's literally a site to keep track of the meta.
Fair enough.
I can actually throw it your way if you want it, for any reason.
Might as well, yeah, because, like, I actually do want to check, because I am pretty certain that that is, like, out of date.
Okay, it might be a little out of date, but it does tend to keep itself up to date as much as it can.
Fair enough.
It's like the Billboard Hot 100 of the Yu-Gi-Oh! Meta.
Fair enough.
So it'll probably update like next week. It probably updates like on a weekly basis. On that note, maybe.
Cause it's like, yeah, cause
And again, it lists it by how many decks are being ran. Not really how strong they are.
Yeah, which, like... last 3 months...
Well, it tends to be... meta is usually defined by what's being ran, not really what's... it's actually not really what's winning, you know? But very commonly, what's winning will be ran. So,
yeah.
Shrug. That's something that nobody really talks about. A meta is not entirely defined by what's winning, it's by what is played the most.
Yeah,
so
which
just
is
collective,
like...
So if just collectively everyone decided, fuck it, we don't want to win anymore, let's just casually build... I don't know, some goofy fucking troll deck with Ecole D-Zone and fucking Summon Limit. You could basically make that the meta.
It is what it is.
But very commonly, it is what wins.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's what... The meta is usually what's popular. And right now, by the looks of it, the meta is Unchained, Kashtira, and Branded, at least within the past 3 months.
So it is the 30th today. I'm gonna see what it's been this week. No statistics, rip. Okay.
Yeah, as I said, it probably updates once a week. That would be my guess.
Fair enough.
Because it has updated within October. It did, it updated for Dortmund, Germany, where an Unchained got top 16.
I could have sworn that Unchained won Dortmund, didn't it? Hold on, let me have a look. Oh no, Dortmund was Rika. Never mind. Yeah, because for some reason, like, European Yu-Gi-Oh! Is just populated by either people who refuse to read what the plant cards do, and people who play nothing but plant and are absolute gods at it. So, like...
Which can't be in... Fall Under right now.
Like, I'm not quite a god at plant, but like I'm getting pretty decent with it, because one of the guys at our locals does lend me his Rika deck from time to time, because unironically it's really really good. Like, because we got we've got to the point where, at the moment, like, the Sunseed Lokai plus any Rika card ends on, like, a tribute their card to Snatch Steal, a tribute anything to negate, a quick effect tribute one of their things just in general, a monster slash spell negate, a compulsory evacuation device, and a... theory on Omni Negate. And apparently, with the newer Aromage cards that are coming out, apparently you won't even need to draw the Rika card to do that anymore. So, it is what it is.
The time it will take so long, I can go make a sandwich, do laundry, and they're still doing combos. Like, bro, I get it, you're compensating for something, just kill me and end the match. I kinda get where the argument stems from, but like... I don't know, I think it's kind of an uncharitable, like... view of Yu-Gi-Oh, because that's... Because realistically, that's only if you're, like, playing competitive. Which, you know, people at Master Duel do, but... Nah, it's like, it's mostly competitive players. So... We're focusing on the idea that if you already have enough to overwhelm and kill me, why keep going? I suppose.
But what's it though? It's because, like... though I will say though, like, in relation to that, it's really, really cringe to see when, like, people who are, like, outsiders to the Yu-Gi-Oh! Community and, like, try to get in through Master Duel, and they, like, because it was similar to that situation with that dog VTuber I've forgotten the name of, but, like, where we get to the point where they are just like, oh, look, like, this this combo took like 15 years and they killed me immediately. And it's just like, yeah, looking at your hand, you had a very obvious way to do so yourself if you used your brain and you just didn't. Only to like complain, oh, Yu-Gi-Oh's so one-sided. And it's just like, no, it's really not one-sided in the way that you're arguing it is. Because again, if you used your brain for 15 seconds, you would have been able to do just the same.
Didn't they hide their hand as well? Like initially?
In that clip from that VTuber, I'm pretty sure they did when they posted it to Twitter. But although that's like not the... that's like honestly not the best example now that I think of it. Because the reason that they didn't combo off there was because they played an Exodia FDK pile with Royal Magical Library. And it's just like, well, no wonder then.
Forgot they played Exodia? Yeah, that's what it looked like.
Yeah, and also, like, the way that this site sorts decks is also really weird, like...
You get used to it. I do agree, though. It could be more streamlined. But you do get used to it.
Because, like, when... When, like, because it just puts the... blanket... Like, the blanket term of synchro... over adventurous synchron... adventurous synchron sprite... Runic Ishizu synchron...
No, again,
Runic
as I said...
Keyboard synchro...
As I said, again, I very much agree. I just... Again, you do kind of get used to it after a while.
Yeah, it is what it is.
You learn to start, like, actually looking at deck lists before you, like, use it as a source.
Yeah, for sure.
Especially if it's something generic like Dragon. Oh my god. They've done that on a few occasions, and it's like, oh boy. What kind of dragon decks?
Especially with how, like, the term Dragon Link is able to apply to decks that use, like, 70 different possible playables. Because, for some reason, Dragon just has everything.
Yeah. Thank you.
You just joined?
Somebody joined? I didn't even hear him.
Yeah, yeah.
You're on streamer mode, that's why you didn't hear me.
Of course.
Well, so it's me, Wing Wolf.
Yo, you good?
Funny furry, how's it going? How's
funny
everyone?
Funny furry in the commentary community narrows it down.
I'm not a commentator.
Oh, you're in these circles, though. That's the point.
I'm aware of the I'm aware of the company I keep. That is pretty funny, though. A lot of my friends, like Susie, like they end up being in commentary circles, but I myself do not engage with that community. So I'm just sitting here like. People will be like, you would not believe what happens today, and I'll be like, ooh, tell me all about it. That's my position in the circle now.
Bruh.
So what have you guys been doing? Like,
just draw.
Yeah.
Talk about Yu-Gi-Oh.
Yeah. No, I checked the stream a bit before jumping in. You're talking about dragon types and shit. You're talking about dragon decks, I mean, and, someone in chat was talking about how much they really don't like Lynx or some shit. I just really don't like Lynx, seemingly.
Yeah, because I mean, we do. Because, like.
God damn it.
Honestly, like, I don't really understand why, a lot of people had as much trouble learning the Link Summon mechanic as they did, because for the most part, it is. Like, it mostly just ended up being, like, synchros, except simpler.
Yeah, that was one of my complaints when, like, it first came out, was that it was, like, too brainless to use.
Yeah, like, because it was, unironically, like, granted, like, I did come to the game during the time where links were already pretty well integrated into the game, well, depending on how you define well integrated, but you get the point, but, like, unironically, it was the easiest one to learn, because it was the one that had the least to it. In terms of, like, just how the monsters are summoned, honestly.
Dude, my Link summoning rant wound up being super fucking on the nose, and I remember somebody, like, trying to get me, he's like, oh, you know, the Link summon, or it's like, you're just mad, you need to adapt or stop playing the game, or just simply don't play meta anymore. It's like, and then everything that I had, every complaint that I had about Link summons turned out to be true.
Yeah,
almost as if I knew what the fuck I was talking about or something. It's like, hey, fun fact. Did you know that when it comes to Yu-Gi-Oh, while I might not know everything, I tend to know what I'm talking about most of the time?
Yeah. Because we just get to the point where you just said, like, yeah, like, if it can be broken on concept alone, then odds are, down the line, it will become a problem, even if things like extra linking are easy to break out of on launch.
Well, no, because the thing is, right, when it came to extra linking, I remember someone was just like, oh, it's only going to be really regulated to very fringe decks. A week later, Nightmares came out.
Yeah, and it's just like, immediately after we get to the point where it's just like, oh yeah, like these extra linking needs monsters that are like so specific that it would require your deck to be built to do nothing but that. Honey, have you read Firewall Dragon? Or at least like the pre-errata text of it anyway. Cause it's just like Firewall just generates extra links out of nowhere, and it's not like Firewall was specifically built to do just that.
I fully acknowledge when I don't know something about Yu-Gi-Oh! And I can usually pick up and learn about it. Usually. I've been playing this game for most of my life.
It is what it is.
It's like I tend to know what I'm talking about. And then there's just this one fucker that's just like, oh, just adapt. It's like, homie, you hate me for I speak the truth.
Or it's like that fucking, that part where they were just like, yeah, extra linking amphor mages, that is all.
Yeah.
And it's like, huh? Like, are you okay? Are you high? If my mans get high on their own supply, like, are you okay? And they were just like, yeah, fucking, the pro Yu-Gi-Oh! Community keeps breaking cards and suddenly it's Konami's fault. Yeah, because Konami are the ones who printed the fucking card, you dumbass.
It's like, my brother in Christ, they printed the cards!
Yeah, like, I'm sorry, but like, fucking Jesse Cotton didn't print Thunder Dragon Colossus, did he?
Now, in some cases, yeah, I will blame the player base, because they will find, like, because they will, like, dig out a really fucking obscure shit card that, like, nobody's thought about in years and find like a really broken strategy with it. Sure, like that can be chalked up to the players. But when they, like, I don't know, ban an entire archetype and then re-release effectively the same archetype, we can blame Konami for that. I'm just saying.
Yeah, like, especially because, like, the example he used was Spiral, because they were just like, yeah, Konami designed Spiral to be this control-based deck, but then they gave it Double Helix, which was enough to break the deck, and suddenly it's Konami's fault. And it's just like, yeah, Konami gave a deck that had, like, five different non-once-per-turn search effects the ability to just e-telly anything from the deck on a link to. Of course that's going to be broken.
Wait, they did that? Yes, they did. The example I'm using is Dragon Rulers and True King. They went and banned the entire Dragon Ruler archetype and then released True King. Like, look, guys. At that point, we can blame Konami.
Yeah, like, when we get the True Kings just, like, killing 2 to 3 babies, summoning, like, 59 dinos from their deck, and then just negating their Nan. Yeah, that's Konami's fault.
You've never heard of Dragon Rulers or True Kings? Oh, then you must be a really new player.
Yeah,
or you haven't played in fucking years.
Yeah, like, either Ultra Boomer or Ultra Zoomer, no in between.
Yeah, because Dragon Rulers fucking dominated, like, an entire era. Very shortly after Dino Rabbits, it was Dragon Rulers. You started during GX, when did you stop?
Yeah.
Because again, dragon rulers were everywhere. They were basically one of the first tier zero decks we had seen since Yatalok. And then, they basically fucking dominated the meta until someone found that you could beat them with Batteryman. And then they went and, then Konami realized how much of a problem dragon rulers were, to the point they basically banned every single dragon ruler and then released True Kings, which did effectively the same thing.
I mean,
dropped out during Xyz and returned near the end of Pendulum. Then that would be the reason why you don't know of dragon rulers, but I don't know how you don't know of True Kings.
Yes,
if you dropped out during the Xyz. If you dropped out during the Xyz era, then that would explain why you don't know dragon rulers, because that was when they basically dominated.
Yeah, when fucking Draco Sack Pass was like the biggest problem to ever face.
Yeah. True Kings, I think, were during the Pendulum era, I think.
Yeah, because like, because it was during 5Ds, because like each of the True Kings were like fighting a different archetype, and Ignimazod was fighting the Metalfos, and Lithosogen was fighting Zoo. And I can't remember what the Water one was fighting, because I've never used the thing.
Yeah, the point is, at that point, we can absolutely blame Konami for the shit that gets broken in the game. Have you guys ever wondered what would happen if you ate a chicken in front of a chicken? They don't really care. Like, chicken will eat chicken.
Hypocrisy doesn't mean they won't do it, though.
Oh, someone redeemed Bimbo Tones? Yeah, that was Shark Jumping Walrus. Could you ask Lynn if the word slag that's written on her cap means the slag element from Borderlands? It does not. I'll tell you that one for free. Slag means exactly what slag usually means.
If you're American and you don't know what it means, then don't worry about it.
Yeah, don't worry about it, bro. Bristan.
Let's just say it's honestly not something a child should be having on a hat, but whatever.
Hence why Lindsay's redesign is not gonna stay. Yeah.
I still remember.
Because, like, as soon as the YouTube bots figure out what it means, I've legit just lost my job.
It does remind me of when I first came in here, saw Lynn Small, I said that should have been written as soup.
It really should have.
Should have. Instead, I just went blah.
Got the soup hat? Makes me think of, like, a variant of that old Vine where it's all like, alright, I got my soup hat on, it's time to fucking party.
Where it's like when Lumi just has like a post-it note over it that just says no.
Yeah, that was also pretty great.
That's fantastic.
Bro, I go to my Discord DMs with Lumi and I see the fucking... the flower enderman. Oh my god, that baby.
It's Enderman.
See me. Scrolling up and I found the roasted Lin Lin image that Susie did.
The what?
The roasted Lin Lin image that Susie did a bit ago, it was so good.
Yeah, so Lin basically put on Twitter, alright, time to roast me, and I was like, alright. I grabbed her character, her Lindsay character, and basically made it look like it was seared onto a bit of pot roast.
That, yeah. I remember that. Because you shared it in the chat here after you did it.
Yeah, it is the second time that I've done that exact joke.
Suzanne. Suzanne, when she has the chance to put her friends' faces in a fucking slab of meat.
I've done it twice, which isn't a lot, but it's weird that I've done it that many times.
I'm guessing it won't be the last.
I mean, I do it anytime someone says to roast them.
Because you're going to find it funny.
Yep. It's a good bit. It's a good move.
It is pretty hilarious. The kids will call it Poggers, or maybe Papago.
As a representative of the miners community, please never do that again.
Okay.
No, you kids.
I'm sorry, that sentence was so fucking stupid. I need you to understand how dumb that sounded when you said that.
As a representative of the miners community, well, y'all got a fucking inner circle now? The council of children?
I mean, yeah, of course there's a council, the Council of Children. It's called the Commentary Community.
Oh, that got me. That was good. That was great.
I'm pretty sure Lindsay's just not gonna have a hat in the redesign, right?
Yeah.
Is that the idea?
Probably.
You never thought you'd hear Danica say Topanga, TBH, you wish you never did. Fair enough.
In my defense, it's Maxar quote.
I mean, true, but like, out of all the Maxar quotes, that's the one you pick.
Half of my vocabulary has been ruined by that man.
Hey guys, Mr. Beast here, and I hid $50,000 inside your skin. The first person to tear it off wins.
Hey everyone, Maxar here.
In this boss fight against Microsoft Excel, we have presented ourselves with a boss that is too large to be fun. This boss involves just waiting for him to do anything, just like Congress. And like Congress, when he does do something, it usually hurts you.
Wow, that joke really hits different. my favorite part. I love that bit he does with Jetstream Sam and Ryan before the Sam boss fight. Where it's all like, you're getting more and more base by the day. It's the whole thing changed where they're just like fucking saying the most terminally online shit at each other.
And yeah.
It's like. That, it's like, but I live with my mother. Is this her house?
Imagine a world, Raiden, where no one can call me out for my outlandish claims. A world where I can say the N-word.
That's like 90% of like, oh god, no, that's horrible. I'm not saying. No, that's bad. No, I'm keeping that one to myself, shit.
I was about to say, Doodletones 2016 through 2018 be like...
Sissy, no!
Alright, I'm gonna get that and I'm actually tweeting that. Oh wait, here it is. It's because it was the thumbnail for that, the stream where we were watching your video with Peaches.
Have you, like...
Yeah?
No, I forgot what I was gonna ask if you caught up in my thing about dumb shit now. Damn. Uh-huh. Didn't expect that, dog. Susie, what the fuck?
I'll take any opportunity to throw myself under a bus, are you kidding?
You're right. I should have expected that.
I'm like, I'm sorry. Do we know each other?
As I say, I should have expected that.
Oh no. Oh my fucking god. I'll put this in there, Mike, because like I was just scrolling my DMs with Lumi. Like, there is so much wrong with this image.
What is this rat?
Like, where does it start and where does it end? Don't even know.
Oh. No.
Let me. Oh, I already do have noise suppression on. Sorry.
Hey, Zara.
Try not to self-deprecate. Challenge impossible. Come on. Yeah. For sure.
Are you saying you're not an artist again?
No, I just threw myself under the bus for saying the N-word in my early commentary career.
What? Oh, I thought you said now. I was like, what?
No,
I've removed. I've tried to remove slurs from my vocabulary.
I was gonna say, Zara, Susie has a lot of problems. That's not one of them anymore.
Anymore.
Oh my god.
Yeah, we have to say anymore.
I love the fact that we have to say anymore. It's very funny.
Well, you weren't entirely. Well, I was like, well, you. Listen, Susie, it's. Listen. You were an entitled white woman back in the day. It's fine. It's okay.
No, the problem with me is that I was in a group. The problem with me saying it back then was that I was in a group that, like, heavily encouraged it. Because, like, literally a year prior to me using it, I made a rant talking about how it was a bad thing to use.
Oh.
And then I got into a raise group.
Of course. But, yeah.
Oh, no. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But,
yeah.
I just want to say, Danica, the way you phrased it, you were an entitled white woman. I'm sorry. Maybe it's the lack of sleep. Maybe it's my headache. But my first thought was like, she's not white anymore?
How much sleep are you currently running on?
Don't know.
Go to bed.
I think 3 hours.
Go to bed.
No, listen.
Get the grab's pillow. Go to bed.
Don't
chuck
me to death.
Listen,
I have an assignment to deal with, and I have dinner to make. I'm gonna sleep early today.
I'm sorry, no. I just remembered this.
Mm-hmm.
I just remembered a meme my mom showed me that had me dying for like an hour. Where it was like...
Dude.
It was like an image where it was all like, sob if it took place in England. And then it's like, guy wakes up in a bathtub. Alright, let's hold this then. The TV turns on. Boy, bruv. Fancy a bit of a game.
I'm sorry. That reminded me of another meme. British people be like, wakes up during heart surgery. Alright, what's all this then?
I love the alright, okay. What's all this then? I mean,
all of these fucking dumbass Americans, if you're gonna mock British people, you can at least pick
American.
One British dialect and stick to it instead of mixing them and then going like, oh, British people sound all stupid, don't they? And it's just like when you mix like 50 different types of British people together, then yeah, I guess so.
Actually, I do have to ask now that you bring that up. How many dialects are there?
American.
Like, no, wait, hold on. No, Zara, we'll deal with the fact you're not American later. Hold on. How many dialects are there?
There's like... that's actually a good question. Let me actually Google it.
To my knowledge, like, from what I've been told from my other British friends, it's kind of like a... You could go down the street and hear, like, an entirely different accent.
So it's like New York.
Yeah, like, there is legit a different accent for East London than there is to West London. Like, but in reality, there are almost 40 different dialects in the UK.
So...
Wild.
Again, so it's like... So it's kind of like a bigger variant of that shit that happens in New York with...
Yeah, but the reason why The reason why I said American there, Zara, wasn't because you're American. It's because of the fact that you see it most frequently in America, like from Americans making those memes, because they're so pathetically trying to claw to an excuse so that they can feel superior.
Honestly, I just like the prospect of British jigsaw being like that's the only reason I laughed at it.
I think the thing that my meme is like that I find funny is just like that British people are inexplicably prone to waking up during heart surgery. I find it so fucking funny.
It's very nonsense, so it becomes hilarious.
Like I don't know. Imagine being born in Britain and the only thing different about you from everyone else is that if you had a heart surgery, you might wake up.
That sounds terrifying, actually. What the shits are?
Which, as far as I'm aware, is untrue.
As far as you're aware.
I'm sorry, but waking up in heart surgery... Unless your doctor... Does it?
It does.
Because it feels like something that shouldn't if your doctor knows what they're doing.
I hate that. I don't like that. Let me explain why.
Okay, so anesthetics. We studied about anesthetics in second year pharmacology.
Second year pharmacology was mental illness.
First year pharmacology. We studied about that, and the thing is, anesthetics. We don't know how they work yet. We don't know the exact mechanism of them. So sometimes they just don't work for some people, and it's either like genetic, it's either depending on brain chemistry, on previous medication. At most, in like 99.9% of times, it works. In the 0.01%, it doesn't, and we don't know how.
I'm going to be paranoid. We don't know how people wake up.
You're a furry. You'll be fine.
And also, it's just like you drink too many cups of tea a day, and you eat beans on toast for lunch, and apparently that means you wake up during heart surgery. Like, yeah, great.
Why does that sound like a? If you said it with the right cadence, that sounds like a Max Tor joke. You eat beans on toast and drink tea every day, and suddenly you can wake up during open heart surgery.
I mean, to be fair, Maxor was the person to say that we should be gathering wheat and dying of smallpox. So,
why would people die of smallpox? It's very avoidable.
You're literally just going like, yeah, smallpox skill issue.
Zara really said.
Just tag the smallpox forehead.
fucking Zara doesn't get smallpox. She literally just it tries to infect her, and you just hear the fucking you hear the fucking Devil May Cry Royal Guard noise where it's like Royal Guard.
Fucking you got fucking smallpox. Literally just side deck forehead.
I mean.
You got Zara, smallpox, bro, cringe.
Bro, you got smallpox? Royal
bro,
guard!
Get good, scrub, get good.
Just dodge, forehead.
Just I see. Someone needs to draw this shit. Just Zara in a hospital being like, bro, just dodge, forehead.
Dodge the smallpox.
I would if I weren't. If I didn't have like a billion assignments, I totally would.
Smallpox isn't a big deal. Just turn off your monitor.
Are you acting like smallpox is an issue? Just turn off the computer.
Yeah, having AIDS isn't a problem. Just turn your immune system back on.
Just reboot the immune system.
Yeah.
Listen. There's no smallpox, there's no burritos, and there's no Queen of England.
I mean, that last part's true.
Oh.
Exactly. All of them are true, excuse you.
I need to
find but yeah, like
there it is. There it is. I found an image. I found an image. Hold on.
And there is no Queen of England. Good.
What? What is this image? What?
Wait, I haven't even made it yet. Hold on.
No, I'm looking at what Lynn posted. Oh, this is so funny. What is this?
The problems with this image, you don't know where they start and where they end.
Exactly. This image is a cognitive hazard.
Hold on. Okay.
Also, I really hope you can't hear me chugging like with juice. Like
I promise you, no one can hear that. Hold on. All right, there we go.
That's great because apparently I swallow really loudly and my sister hates it.
There we go. There you go, Zara. Royal Guard! Fucking. Zara be like, smallpox? Just Wahoo Wacky Pizza Man, that shit. What are you talking about?
Yeah, just do the parry. Just do the parry from Ultra Kill.
Hold on, I have a perfect image. Let me. Wait, why is there so much dank of vampires? Anyway.
Yeah, Susie.
When you walk into the
OST is good.
I say, when you walk into the commentary community, good. Why is there so much stank in Rampa? That is literally.
Hold on, I have
to tell you.
I have friends who like don't engage with the CC that literally see Danganronpa as a commentator franchise, and I think that's hilarious.
I mean, are they wrong?
No, that's why it's funny. Literally, it's like walking into the commentary community, it'd be like, why is there so much Danganronpa? Why do you think I had a fucking fit when I saw in my sub box the kill count, Danganronpa Trigger Happy Havoc? What do you mean Dead Meat did a video on Danganronpa? What do you mean I have to live with this now?
Why is there a kill count? We already know, like, how many people die.
Oh, Susie. Oh.
Oh, no.
Darling. Let me explain. Okay, so for the past, I think, 5 years now, I think that's how long the channel's been up. There's been this YouTube channel. Yeah.
I found the perfect image. Hold on. Okay. I'm sorry. I don't want to interrupt you. I found the perfect image. I just want to send it now. Like the head to them.
That's
anyway. Carry on.
But there's been a YouTube channel called Dead Meat that does a weekly series called Kill Count. And due to the strikes, they've had to basically do more out there kill count videos. So they did Don't Hug Me, I'm Scared. They did Danganronpa. Recently, they did Immensus Blue of all fucking things. Honestly, I kind of hope that even after the strikes end, Dead Meat keep doing these weird fucking kill counts, because I actually kind of like them. It's kind of out of the usual wheelhouse I expect from the channel. And I always love it when long-running YouTube series just do weird shit. Like, that's my favorite thing. Like, YouTubers, normalize doing weird shit with your content. It's pretty epic.
Yeah. So true.
Fucking, I'll just ramble and say something, and then Zara will be like, so true. No, Zara, I like it, because it's like, I'm imagining, like, 7-foot-tall wolf being, like, saying, like, explaining something, and then the tiny little Zara being like, so true, bestie.
So true, indeed. Also, look at No Mic. The gift.
Just,
that's
just
me
touch
as
it. Just touch it.
Why does he look that racist? Lynn being able to sense the Hitler particles. Dude, I love Lennon memes. They just, they're so fucking stupid. Like, what the fuck does this mean?
Sheesh.
I see. So you deny your immune, you deny your immune system its purpose.
You deny your immune system. End the sentence there.
No, I'm still stuck on the fucking smallpox jokes. So like now,
may I fight smallpox?
Now,
deny,
now,
sit down.
Now I'm picturing where it's like smallpox, just boss, it's like. When the smallpox try to enter Zara's immune system, it's like, why do I hear boss music? The man in the mirror, Nazis yet.
By the way, I've wound up befriending another person who does like a lot of music references that I just instinctually play off of.
Oh, please tell me more. I need this person. I need people like that in my life, dog.
Well, it's one of Lumi's friends that I've been watching watching Lumi go through Danganronpa with.
That's epic. That's so cool.
I initially started watching because Lumi wanted to prove to me that this friend can indeed just predict the most whack shit. I didn't believe at first. Now I do. And now I've seen it firsthand.
It's crazy, dog.
They will joke about the most whack shit that's just like, oh yeah, that's gonna happen later in the game. Obviously, we don't tell them, but...
It does, in fact, get pretty funny how often it happens, I guess.
The memes I'm making out of this are so incomprehensible.
You get like a fucking... You study medicine and suddenly you can parry the... You can parry the diseases.
Simply tech the smallpox.
Fucking smallpox spread in Zara's system, and you just hear the beginning. You begin hear the beginning notes of "Find Your One Way," and then, like, it's like smallpox. Man, I sure do love entering Zara's immune system. Zara, counter, 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 slash.
Hey, what the hell?
See, Zara, the joke is guilty here.
You know, Zara's the heart counter to smallpox.
Why didn't I, like... Huh. My internet just, like, died.
Are you back?
Oh. I'm back now. I hadn't heard a thing. I just heard, so you study medicine, and then silence. And then Danica goes, so the joke is guilty gear.
That's probably funnier because it's like, it's like, it's one of those, like it fades out in the middle of my explanation, and then it fades back in, and it's like, so anyway, the joke is guilty gear. You know, the fighting game played by gay people.
Is that speaking all of them?
Speaking of gay... Well... Okay, listen. It's not my point.
Anyway, speaking of gay people?
Speaking of gay people, that reminded me of something I saw last night. So apparently, I found this in someone's in one of my mutual's Twitter likes, and I thought it was the greatest thing ever. The creator of Metalocalypse, Brandon Small, was asked what his what he thinks of the fan art for Metalocalypse, and his answer was, "Oh, I love all of it. The homosexual stuff's my favorite." And I love the quote, "The homosexual stuff is my favorite." I just wanted everyone to have that quote in their back pocket. The homosexual stuff is my favorite.
Me when I read the choppy.
I would say that's Zara about Toho. The homosexual
Zara
stuff
about a lot of things.
I was gonna say, Zara is literally in my head, when I think of Zara, I literally think of like the lesbian flag. I won't even lie.
Just that flag with like a flaming skull in front of it, that's me.
Gay woman enjoyer. No, that's what I'm thinking about. I'm another smallpox joke. Wow, smallpox, just be a lesbian forehead. Skill issue.
Exactly. Everyone knows we are immune to smallpox.
Give me 1 second. Hold on.
I'm almost done with the fucking. Almost done with the line art, and then I'll probably call it a stream. Go see if I need to write ponder or heat.
Getting super like conversational in the block for some reason.
By the way, I think this looks this is looking really sick so far. By the way, I've really been digging these art streams.
Yeah, it's just chill.
Working again?
Think so.
Okay, yeah, you are no longer a incompatible robot noises. Okay, great. My fantastic. I just wanted to say, I'm gonna go get some sugar for the tea because I drank too much tea today.
Well, you have a good time. Be sure to parry all smallpox.
Yes, I will. I will parry all smallpox. I will dodge it. I hope you guys have a good day. I hope that you enjoy drawing, and I hope that you dodge in general. Dodge smallpox. Dodge your responsibilities. Dodge impending doom. Okay, goodbye.
Oh my god.
What?
TP was sampled in a Silva Gunner rip?
TP?
Yeah, it's at the end!
Which one?
Circus the PP Poom Poo Mix. I hate that I had to say that out loud.
Have you posted in the...
No, he posted about it on, like, his Twitter page. He was all like, what do you mean I'm in a silver gunner rip?
I'm gonna have to hear this.
It's at the actual end of it. I'm like, what the shit? Never in my life did I think one of my friends would be fucking in a silver gunner rip.
Let me pull it up. Okay. Circus,
the pee pee poo poo mix. I linked it in the chat. No, Mike, if you need that.
Oh, okay. It'd be awesome if my. Alright, we're gonna mute this music, we're gonna move our sound over here. Alright, let's hear this.
You know, it says something when I prefer
the bite of 87
over watching your
Cyvic. Oh no, he's sampled all throughout it! Extended periods
of time. What do you mean he's sampled all throughout it?
I'm at the very beginning of it.
I only recognize him at the end. Like, literally him talking.
Then it just turns into CG5.
Yeah, nah.
But, like, he's at the very beginning.
And he's at the very end, too. Like I said, like, that's where I recognize him. I didn't realize he was at the beginning. But no, fucking TP.
Why is TP in a fucking Five Nights at Freddy's rip?
I don't know. That's the crazy part. That's what I don't... that's what I'm trying to figure out. In the big blue house. Why is it TP of all people, too? Like, that's the crazy part. Like, I wouldn't exactly call TP, like, popular, or, like, main, or, like, really big, so, like, how'd this happen, dog? That's crazy.
I have no idea. Oh, he's also, him and Bop are both credited in the composer section.
Oh, that's a wow.
Ayo! He getting proper credit out here, too.
That's a CC reference on a Silver Gunner rip. Okay. I did not expect that.
Why, though? That's such a random reference to put. It's like, this is a niche-ass fucking community.
That's what's getting me. Like, it's not just that TV's in it. Like, as a sample, but also just, like, the general... The general dangling grandpa Pokemon avatar community is getting fucking referenced in your fucking high quality rips. That's the crazy shit. Like, Silver Gunners has in fact had a bunch of strange samples in the past I never expected.
I would have expected Blaze the movie fan out of anyone from the SCC.
But TP?
The TP, man.
Fucking
way to go, my dude.
Let's go, TP. Holy shit. Okay.
Yeah, we let my man cook.
Homie literally in the Freddy Fazbear.
Hold on.
Gunner Circus rip.
No, imagine that.
Scythe the Gunner Circus rip.
Just run over by a car and dies.
Okay. I just wanted to hear the last bit.
Yeah.
Hey, yo, my boy.
That's where I recognized it was him.
The last yeah, no, he's in the beginning, too.
So you said. I'm just like, how?
That's sick, man.
How did we get here?
Is Blaze a movie fan of Music Man? No. But he is the closest thing the SCC has to a celebrity.
I was like, He did, in fact, do Mario Pissing.
He did Mario Pissing and the Alex the Lion. What are you doing?
What are you
my
doing
car?
In my? No, I actually made a meme of that once, where it was all like, "Alex the Lion, what are you doing in my car?" Because it was the joke. Was,
yeah.
It's point the being, real, it's the real Friends lyric. Yeah.
Yeah. Point being, yeah, I
what
expect Blaze the movie fan before anyone else. Jesus, let's go.
It would be really funny if the, imagine if you had a blank. Now imagine if that got hit by a car, became like, just like a meme template from now on.
Dude, TP becoming a meme would be fucking insanity.
Now imagine it got hit by a car. I don't know what's weirder, TP being part of a Silver Gunner FNAF rip or TP being a part of a Silver Gunner FNAF rip that has CG5 in it.
You know what's also really crazy? Fucking Ty getting referenced in a death battle video.
What?
Yeah.
When did that happen? Hold on.
That was the Bill Cipher one. Bill Cipher
the one
versus Discord.
Yeah, I didn't watch that one. That explains why.
Yeah.
Because that was in the era. That was in the era where I was just impatiently waiting for Death Battle to actually do Alex versus Cole, which
yeah,
they
Ty
did
was,
do.
Ty was referenced in that video because they had like, what was it? Bill Cipher's real name, and it was just cycling through a bunch of popular Death Battle YouTubers, and Ty was one of them.
That's crazy. See, but that at least you could make like a logical through line for it because, like,
I just think it's cool.
It is cool. Don't get me wrong. It just fucks me up that TP was in a Silver Gunner.
Again, the fact that Bob was also credited, like,
damn,
wild, man.
There is a higher than 0% chance that Susie will get sampled in a Silver Gunner rip one day.
Yeah, that has now become a less than 0 chance.
Damn, now I kind of want.
Am I worried about that? Very much so, actually.
Why? It'd be epic.
Because I do, friendly reminder, I don't have the best, reputation.
I'm aware.
So.
But you're cool. So, counter argument, you're epic.
Yeah, but that wouldn't change why I'd be afraid of, like, a channel as big as fucking Siva Gunner. Fucking sampling me.
Still, I'm just thinking because, like, it's so strange hearing TP's voice in that. Like, that threw me off.
Oh, no, for sure, for sure. And again, way to go, TP.
Fucking, let's give some golf claps to the homie. Let's go.
Give it to the bean. What the fuck even is this style that I've just, like, been drawing? Anyway. Guess this is the highlight to TP's year? Oh, probably. Anyway, with that, I've been going for 2.5 hours. I said I'd probably finish up the image off stream. So, let's see, who do I go and raid? still going? No, Heaton's not going. Ponder's not going. I guess I could rate Gius. I don't... He's someone I've... This man usually doesn't stream around the time that I do, but he has been a very good source of entertainment when I wake up, like, at midnight and can't get back to sleep. So I'm gonna go ahead and rate him. He's currently doing Clone Hero, so... Alright. Later, chat.